successful entrepreneurs weren't sitting around waiting for things to happen. The moral lesson is that as a business person, do not settle until your set goals are actualized. Good evening and welcome to The Business Show. Here now are stories that made headlines in the world of business, locally and internationally. Traders, manufacturers commit to illicit trade fights. UCC warns of rising numbers of fraudsters. Seacom extends operations to Uganda. KFC sales plunge as China COVID cases surge. Oil prices fall below $100. Petrol hits new high.
In 2014, we went into the enterprise space. The enterprise space is really now for businesses, the large businesses and the SME businesses.
When you're buying from China, you're blocking out all these other people that could have benefited from you purchasing Ugandan products.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, the pricing of the internet, its reliability and accessibility in Uganda has for a long time been blamed on government's failure to establish infrastructure. However, experts believe that the reliability of internet and even affordability goes beyond infrastructure. On Views from the Top tonight, we host the Managing Director, Seacom East Africa, who says that healthy competition among service providers could actually breed a drop in the pricing of internet in Uganda.
Thanks very much. So my name is Tejpal Bedi. I'm the MD for Seacom East Africa. I've been in the ICT industry for the last 25 years. One of the first ISPs in Kenya, and then being part of Dimension Data up until 2011, and then into the education business with IBM, and then the last business I ran, we were a Salesforce.com platinum partner, and now with Seacom East Africa.
All right, so we know for a fact that Seacom has been in Uganda somehow, but not really in the outer. This week you're here now, and what does this mean generally?
So when the cable landed in 2009, a lot of telcos and a lot of service providers bought services from us. So this is what we call the wholesale business. And that's where Seacom started. In 2014, we went into the enterprise space. The enterprise space is really now for businesses, the large businesses and the SME businesses. And from there on, we were actually officially selling out to companies from 2014. We hold a service provider license that gives us ability to sell all over Uganda. And now, obviously, we've purchased some assets, and those assets will give us a better way of reaching our potential customers and to grow our customer base, and hence now the expansion program in Uganda. So really, we are not new to Uganda, but the consumers will not hear about us,
okay,
because it's more an enterprise business-oriented B2B company.
All right, so who are exactly your target audience or your targeted consumers?
Organizations, businesses that are looking to connect to the internet, companies that have branches from Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania would have been talking to us. We have local Ugandan companies that are only in Uganda, also our customers, and this really, our investment in Uganda is about now focusing more on Uganda and really giving more product range to what we've had in Kenya as well.
Okay, there's been a popular talk of if anyone wants internet, it has to be reliable. Yeah, because we know for a fact that you get data and then...
So you can be positive. I think, first of all, people have respected our IP services, the companies that connect to us, and see that, you know, our speeds are faster because we are connecting them directly to the backbone. We have less contention ratios, meaning that we are not overselling our bandwidth. We have security on top of that, which customers can buy. One of our products that you know, we are launching in the market, it's called denial of distributed DOS, DDoS, distributed denial of service. And what we are going to do with companies that buy that service is really that we are going to block the denial of service attacks from our side. So that's one thing that we've invested in the network, improved the network for better security. For companies that have wide area networks, meaning they have branches, there's a product that we have launched in Kenya and are launching here, which will really be software-defined wide area networks. What that really means, it's called SD-WAN. It's really a product that will able to give companies better control on their bandwidth and more efficiency on their bandwidth, saving them money or giving them better speeds. So as a mobile user of the internet, you're not my customer. So it's really a hotel like this one, a manufacturer, an insurance, a bank, an SME business would be our potential customer. Perhaps the mobile operator buys internet from us on the wholesale, but we would never go to the end user. So our focus has been really on enterprise and SME businesses.
Which then is going to bring my next question. We know that some businesses, or most businesses, when they're getting into the market, they would rather go big, target almost everything, and then when they don't make the actual sales, they start, you know, stepping back and saying, I think we should focus on this. What is the importance of focusing on a particular market audience every time you're entering a market?
You can't serve all the markets. And there's always a limited resource that you want to spend, and you have to focus on a market. It's really the marketing rules of, you know, your core competence. What are you good at? You can't be a jack of all trade and master of none. You got to focus, and that focus should be able to give you that you look after that particular target market well. And so our focus has been in this market, in the enterprise and the SME space, but more on the enterprise. And now with the infrastructure, the investment, we'll be able to also look after the SME part of the business. So look, we're very excited. This, you know, what we're doing in Uganda is very exciting for us. 2022 is going to be a milestone for Secom. We are growing our human resource in country, and that'll continue to grow this year and the years to come. There's been investments, as our group CEO said, at the moment, and for the next 5 years there'll be even more investments into Uganda. It's an important market for us, and this event today is really goes to show our commitment to the country. And again, we're very grateful to the government agencies that have been extremely helpful making a conducive environment for foreign companies to come and invest and work together in Uganda. So I would say thank you very much, and we look forward to a fantastic 2022.
Well, Secom extended operations into Uganda, and observers say that this could actually be a game changer for internet usage in the country. We now take a quick break, but the business show continues shortly.